Goodwill Community Foundation, creating opportunities for a better life.
When you're creating a Word document that includes a list of items, like this meeting agenda, you can format it as either a bulleted or numbered list. First, you'll need to select the text. To add bullets, you can just click the Bullets command, and if you ever want to remove them, you can just click here again. For more options, you can click the Bullets drop-down arrow and select the style that you want. If you click at the end of a list item and then press the Enter key, the next line will automatically have the same list formatting. When you're done, just press Enter twice, and the next line will have the normal formatting without bullets. Now there's another part of this document that I want to format as a numbered list. To do this, select the text, and then click the Numbering command, or use the drop-down arrow to select the style that you want. I'd like to split this up into two lists with a heading in between steps 5 and 6. So I'll click here and press Enter twice. You can see that after the heading, it has continued the numbering starting with step 6. If you'd like to change that, all you have to do is right-click the number and go to Restart at 1. If you want to change it back, just right-click the number and select Continue Numbering. Now I'm going to go back to the top and select my bulleted list. I'd like to change these bullets to something different, but when I click the drop-down arrow, I don't see one that I want. That's okay because there are lots of other symbols that we can choose from. Just go to Define New Bullet and click Symbol, then select a font. I recommend using any of the Wingdings fonts because they have a lot of symbols to choose from. You can then scroll through the list of symbols, and when you found one you like, select it and click OK. While I'm here, I think I'll customize it a little more. Click Font, and let's change the color of the bullet. I'm going to choose this green color. Click OK to close these dialog boxes, and your bullets will appear in the document. Now there's a third type of list that we haven't talked about yet, called a multi-level list. A multi-level list is basically just an outline, and the great part about them is that you can easily turn any bulleted or numbered list into a multi-level list. For example, under News and Events, I'd like to list some specific news items. I'll press Enter to create a new item, and then press Tab on my keyboard. Then I can type each item, pressing Enter after each one. If you want to increase the level of one of the lines, just click at the beginning of the line, and then press the Tab key one or more times. And if you want to decrease the level of a line, hold the Shift key and press Tab, and it will move to the left. Just like with any list, you can change the bullet or numbering style. If you click on a list item and select a different bullet, it will change all of the items on that level. You can also reformat the entire list by clicking the multi-level list command and then selecting one of the built-in styles. So there are a lot of different ways that you can format your lists, and you can tailor them to fit the style of your document.